All right. And so this week in my classes, I've been working on this idea of accepting and trusting. So right now we all find ourselves in a time that is very challenging, very uncertain, very new for all of us. And kind of our initial reaction to that is to deny it, to try and run away from that. And that isn't really going to work in this time. Rather, we have to accept the present moment as it is and take it for what it is, and then move through it with a sense of trust that we're ultimately being guided to where we're meant to go, that we are going to make it through okay. And that doesn't mean that there isn't going to be negativity along the way and that there are going to be things that are hard, but just trusting in that process and trusting in your own power to navigate those hard times to the other side. So that's what we're going to explore today on our mats. And we'll begin on our backs. Way you'd like to get started. So you can go ahead and find your way into Shavasana or Supavadakonasana, collapse bridge, really whichever space feels best to you, go there and do that. Start to release movements and find stillness. Start to allow your eyes to close and go inward. And just start to breathe and integrate into this time and this space. To begin, take a deep breath in, fill up your lungs to your very fullest capacity, and hold your breath for 3, 2, 1. Open mouth, exhale, release anything that doesn't serve, and fully arrive here on your mat. Start to turn on and engage your Ujjayi breath as you're ready. Inhales through your nose, and exhales through your nose. Long, smooth inhales, with long, smooth exhales. Give your breath a sound and a texture. Cultivate it deeper and deeper. And from there, friends, we layer on our greater point of intention and meditation for our practice together. Today is all about finding acceptance of this present moment, no matter what it holds. Trusting that no matter what, we are going to navigate this time and arrive on the other side, this too shall pass. And that doesn't mean that along the way there won't be hardships and even tragedies. But we have to trust that we are going to make it through, we are going to learn, we are going to grow from this, and it will not always be this way. So as you move throughout the challenges of this practice, I invite you to just lean into those moments of challenge, of discomfort, rather than trying to guess, seek, or avoid. Take it as it comes, breathe through it, and trust in yourself. You have what it takes. That's the mentality we work with here. And that's what we take with us off our mats and out into the world. Take another deep Ujjayi inhale. And deep Ujjayi exhale. Inhale, bend your knees towards your chest. Exhale, hug your knees into your chest. Give yourself a squeeze and gently rock side to side to massage out your low back. And come to center. Bring your legs to a reverse tabletop position. Stack your knees over your hips and bring your arms to a T or a goalpost shape. Inhale, drop your knees over to the left side of your room and hover your knees about 3 inches from the mat. Exhale, pull your knees back to center over your hips. Inhale, drop your knees down to the right and hover them a few inches from the mat. Exhale, pull your knees back to center over your hips. We continue. Down to the left, inhale. Up to the center, exhale. Down to the right, inhale. Up to the center, exhale, and continue on your own. Strive to keep your knees stacked over your hips and your heels in line with your knees. This will activate into your entire abdominals even more. Full 360 core activation as you use your upper four pack to descend your knees and the action of your belly button snap into your spine to pull your knees back to center over your hips. We're here for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, and to the right in 2, come back to the center and 1, and release, hug both knees in and squeeze. Now begin to rock forward and back 3 to 4 times the full length of your spine. And on your last time, cross your ankles, plant your hands, and make your way forward to a tabletop position, all fours. Come to stack your shoulders over your wrists, your hips over your knees, and find a flat spine as you exhale. Inhale, cow, vidalasana. Drip your belly down, bend your elbows, pull your chest through and gaze forward. Exhale, cat, pull your belly to your spine, round your spine, point the crown of your head and your tailbone down, do up the space between your shoulder blades. Now flow these two postures out of your own pace of breath. Add on any other movements you feel called to perform to warm up in this space. No right or wrong, just take what feels right to stretch early on in the morning. Link your breath and your body together, have them move in sync. And layer on this intention. Inhale, acceptance of this moment and all it brings. Exhale, a release of resistance or avoidance. Inhale, trust in the process. Exhale, cultivate trust in your own strength and potential here. Start to even out your movements. If you took anything with a right or a left, find equality on both sides. Come to neutral in 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale, bird dog. Reach your right arm forward towards the front, thumb up like you're shaking someone's hand. Exhale, lift your left leg above the mat, left heel towards the back room, pause. Flex your toes down and square your hips down. Remain here on the inhale, reach in opposite direction. Exhale, draw your elbow to your knee underneath your body, belly up and in around your spine. Two more, inhale, reach. Exhale, round. Inhale, reach. Exhale, round. Inhale, reach, this is a change. Exhale, bring your left knee down. Inhale, reach your right arm high towards the sky. Use that past your fingers with a stretch in your right pectoral. Exhale, thread the needle. Bring your arm underneath your body, right shoulder and side of head down. Now you have some options here. Your left hand can stay as it is. You can extend your arm forward straight. You can also take a half line behind your back. If you would like balance challenge, extend your left leg up the mat, left heel towards the back of the pause. Wherever you are, inhale, energy out your tailbone towards the back. Exhale, pull your belly button up and in, invite stability into the rest of your body. Take one more full round of breath here. Inhale. Exhale, bring your left knee down. Clench your left hand back underneath your shoulder. Inhale, push the mat away, unravel and rise, reach your right arm high one more time, stretch up your chest. Exhale, tabletop. You keep that direction and then turn direction. Inhale, bird dog, reach your left arm forward towards the front, thumb up. Exhale, reach your right leg up and back, and pause. Flex your toes down and square your hip down. Remain here on the inhale, reach in opposite direction. Exhale, draw your elbow to your knee underneath your body, belly up, then round spine. Two more, inhale, reach, extend. Exhale, round, build heat, power, and focus. Inhale, reach. Exhale, round. Inhale, reach, listen for the change. Exhale, bring your right knee down. Inhale, reach your left arm high, use the past your fingers to the stretch in your left pectoral. Exhale, thread the needle. Move into the same depth and variation on each of them on the other side. So your hand can stay planted, you can walk your arm straight, you can take the half bind. If you want the balance challenge, right leg up and back, pause. Inhale, energy out your tailbone back. Exhale, gather abdominals up and in, find the stability. Breathe in. Exhale, bring your right knee down. Plant your right hand back underneath your shoulder. Inhale, push the mat away, unravel and rise, reach your left arm high, one more time, stretch. Exhale, tabletop. Inhale, curl your toes. Exhale, downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana, lift your hips and gaze between your feet. Find some organic movement here. You can walk out your down dog, you can shake your hips, shake your head, do what feels right, get the snaps and the cracks out. Warm physically to go deeper into the practice, energetically, mentally into the meditation piece. Invite stillness into your down dog. Inhale, gaze forward. Exhale, ragdoll uttanasana. Step your feet up behind your wrists. Bring your feet hip distance apart or as wide as your mat. Take a generous bend to your knees. Let your belly rest on your thighs. Let your head drop. Grab off the elbows. You can stay still or sway side to side. Release physical tension from the back end of your body. Release mental, energetic blockages. Again, those points of resistance and doubt, they fall away.
inhale, center. Exhale, release your hands down. Bring your left hand to the center of your mat, right underneath your face. If you have a yoga block or a book, you can also place this here. Inhale, ragdoll twist. Bend your left knee, straighten your right leg, reach your right arm high towards the sky, pause and breathe. On your inhale, reach up to your right finger. Hold on your exhale, stuff your belly in. Roll your right shoulder blade towards the nice edge of the mat behind you to open your chest. Breath in. Exhale, release your right hand down. Switch out your hands on the mat or the block. Inhale, ragdoll twist. Bend your right knee, straighten your left leg, reach your left arm high, hold and breathe. On your inhale, reach up to your left finger. Hold on your exhale, pull your belly in. Blow your left shoulder towards the nice edge of the mat behind you to open your chest. Breathe in. Exhale, release your left hand down. Toe heel your feet to a comfortable distance. Your toes can touch or be hips distance. Take a long inhale and slowly rise. One vertebra at a time. Stack bone on bone on bone. Your head is the last to come up. Strong standing position. Once you're up at the top, inhale, roll your shoulders up by your ears. Exhale, draw your shoulder blades down your spine. And find standing at attention. Soma CPD, hands to heart center. Allow your eyes to close. Root down to the floor, bring your feet physically into your mat, energetically into this space, this time of acceptance and trust you're stepping into today. Pull this to your body and your being and pause. Dear friends, we unite our class with breath and intention. This goes beyond just a physical exercise and calorie burn. This also becomes our moving meditation. To begin, open mouth, exhale, release the resistance and the avoidance. Let that all go. Inhale, breathe in acceptance to this time and all that it brings. Open up, exhale, breathe that around you, move with that sense of acceptance. Now inhale, breathe in trust of the process, the growth that inspires. Open up, exhale, move with that trust. Once again, even deeper, inhale, breathe in trust in yourself. You have what it takes, you can, you will. Open up, exhale, breathe that around you, take that with you for the practice and beyond. Blink eyes open, release your arms down. Inhale, Mountain Tadasana, push your feet, lift your arms, bring your biceps by your ears. Pause, breathe, build. Maintain the engagement in your lower body. Pull your thighs up off your knees and squeeze your glutes. Pull your belly button back to your spine. Knit your front ribs together and down. Descend your shoulder blades down your back so that you're creating a lengthy neck. Inhale, float your arms from your hips, couple holes or inch taller. Exhale, quarter moon. Slide your right hand down your right thigh. Reach your left hand up and over to the right side of the rib cage. Square your hips and your shoulders forward through your breath. On your inhale, create space between your left ribs and your left hip bone. On your exhale, contract your right side body to reach over by 1 more inch and intensify the stretch. Inhale, Mountain Tadasana rock. Exhale, quarter moon. Slide your left hand down your left thigh. Reach your right hand up and over to the left and pause. Square your hips and your shoulders forward. On your inhale, create space between your right ribs and your right hip bone. On your exhale, contract your left side body to reach up and over by 1 more inch. Inhale, Mountain Tadasana rise. Exhale, back bend on Uttanasana. Shift the weight into your heels, squeeze your glutes, tuck your tongue, and broaden to your chest nice and wide. Inhale, Mountain Rise, knit your front ribs together. Exhale, forward fold, Uttanasana, bend the knees, fold in half at your hips, release down to plat spine, and release your hands down to the bottom. Inhale, halfway lift, bring your hands onto your shins or your thighs, extend the behind your head, and tabletop your back nice and flat. Exhale, squat and curl, plant your hands, lift your heels, and tuck into a little ball shape here, to your chest. Inhale, invite space between each vertebra on your spine. Exhale, tuck your chin to your chest tighter, and drop the space between your shoulder blades wider. All right, friends, we're gonna flow this sun A and add onto it one at a time. Inhale, Mountain Tadasana, drop your heels, roll up, rise up, reach up, engage everything, feet, two fingers on. Exhale, quarter moon, up and over to your right. Inhale, Mountain Tadasana, rise. Exhale, quarter moon, up and over to your left. Inhale, Mountain Tadasana, rise. Exhale, back bend, open up body, mind, and heart. Inhale, mountain rise, absorb ribs. Exhale, forward fold, dive down, fluid and smooth. Inhale, halfway lift, flat your spine. Exhale, squat and curl. Listen for the change as we add on. Inhale, halfway lift again. Exhale, high plank, bend off, and plant your hands and set both of your feet back. Inhale, shift forward. Exhale, lower all the way down to your belly. Flip to the tops of your feet, Glue your toenails down. Bring your hands by your chest and your elbows in. Exhale. Inhale, baby cobra, bhujangasana. Feel your chest from the mat a little to weight your neck. Keep your gaze down so your neck is long. Push your toenails down. Squeeze your thighs and glutes. Bring your shoulders kiss, send them back at the same time. Reach your crown of your head forward. Inhale, fill up by one more rib. Exhale, release. Bring your right cheek to that. Gaze towards the left. Heels flop open. Arms right down. Breathe and relax. Inhale, bring your chin to center. Reach your fingers back in a low V formation, kind of like an airplane. Exhale. Inhale, locust shell and bottom A. Feel your chest up like cobra. Reach your fingers back. Exhale, low corner to your belly. Float your legs up. You're balancing on your belly and your hip bones. Inhale, pull up. Reach your fingers back. Exhale, pull, lift your legs up. Take one more inhale, fly higher. Exhale, release. Opposite cheek to the mat and relax down. Inhale, bring your chin to center. Plant your hands beneath your shoulders and tuck your toes. Exhale, down dog. Rise to a high plank or tabletop, then lift up and back. Inhale, gaze forward. Exhale, forward fold. Step foot or handstand to travel to the top. Inhale, halfway lift, flat spine. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, mountain rise. Pull energy, earth through finger. Exhale, quarter moon to your right. Inhale, mountain. Find acceptance for yourself in this moment. Exhale, quarter moon to the left. Release resistance and avoidance. Inhale, mountain. Trust in this process. Exhale, back bend. Trust in yourself. Inhale, mountain. We grow together. Exhale, forward fold. We move through this together. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, squat and curl. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, high plank. Plant your hands, set both feet back, and hold your high plank. I want you to reach your heels back and your inner collarbones forward. Squeeze your thighs and glutes. Pull your abdominals up and in. Push the mat away and jump the space with your shoulder blades. Now, friends, holding high plank for a posture like this is not easy. It's not going to feel great, but we are going to have to breathe through it and trust that we have the strength that we need to get through it. That's the mentality shift we practice here for 3, 2, 1. Inhale, shift forward. Exhale, chaturanga, lower half down. Inhale, up dog. Flip tops your feet. Shine your chest and your gaze lower. Exhale, down dog. Pull through your belly button. Lift up and back. All right, friends, as always in my classes, we go 2 more times through Sun A. These Sun A's are yours. It's your breath, your movements, moving freely, and really getting connected to what's in your heart this intention today. Inhale, gaze forward to the top of your space. Exhale, forward fold. Step, put your hands in to get to the top. You're on your own, 2 full Sun A's. You can do the same Sun A we just did, or you can do something totally different. If you want to do some cartwheels and somersaults around your house, that's fine. As long as you're doing it with your breath. And again, you're really focusing in on this intention of being present, being open, finding the trust, going inward, and moving strong. Once you are done, downward facing dog. I'll see you there.
Say we're just friends, but I swear when nobody's around, I keep my eye on your neck, looking at are you feeling it out? 'Cause I am. I'm not so hotter than that. I swear to God, from my feet and hit the ground. Oh yeah, you got against the wall. This is all you've been talking about in my ears. Nothing feels better than this. Nothing feels better. Nothing feels better than this. Nothing feels better.
Wonderful movements and variations, friends. I can see some of you flowing. That's what it's all about. We are in separate rooms, but we are flowing together, We are moving into that space of being able to breathe into the challenge and the discomfort of this time and navigate it with that openness, looking for the growth, looking for the change. Once you are done, down dog in 4, 3, 2, and 1, downward facing dog. Take a big breath in, open mouth exhale, and let go. All right, friends, we move forward and we build the bulk of our class Sun B. Rather than trying to guess at what's coming or when it's over, can you really just accept each posture, each movement as it comes up? And no matter how hard or uncomfortable it is, breathe into it. Trust yourself through it. Inhale, gaze forward.
Exhale, forward fold. Step foot or hands into the top of your face. Inhale, halfway lift, flatten your spine. Exhale, forward fold, dive down. Inhale, chair, weight into your heels, bend your knees, sit your hips back, reach your arms up, hold and breathe. Shift the weight into your heels so that your toes are lighter, but still keep them down as anchor points. Squeeze your knees and thighs together like you've got newspaper between them. Pull your belly in, plug your shoulder blades down your back. Breathe in. Exhale, chair plane, reach your arms back, bring your shoulder blades together, and ignite through your triceps. Inhale, chair, shift weight into your right foot. Exhale, full airplane, send your left leg back, reach your arms back, hinge your body parallel to that, and hold. Feel free to have a bend to your right knee. It doesn't have to be completely straight. Square your hips to the ground, pull your belly in. Plug your shoulders down your back and send them towards your hips, similar to a locust pose. Breathe in and breathe out. Inhale, crescent. Bend your right knee, land your left toes as they land. Lift your torso, bring your biceps by your ears. Pause, breathe, build. Bring a slight bend to your back knee. Square your hips forward. Right back, left forward, tailbone underneath. Knit your front ribs together and down. Descend your shoulder blades down your back. Similar mountain pose from your hips to your fingertips. Breathe in. Exhale, revolve, crescent, tap. Bring your hands to your heart center, shift forward. Literally just tap your left elbow to your right knee for one hot second. Inhale, warrior two, swing your back heel down. Stay low in your front leg. Cut your arms, create air, take your stance and plug in. Pause and breathe. Seal down into the night as your feet so your inner arch is lift. Draw your right knee to the wall that is behind you. Stack your shoulders over your hips. Lengthen your arms equally, right and left, gaze forward, perhaps shut down your eyes. Now, friends, no matter what you're feeling and experiencing in this space, breathe into it, navigate through it, trust yourself you can. Breathe in, exhale, extend side angle, shift forward, bring your right elbow to your right thigh and reach your top arm towards the sky. Stay rooted into your left leg and lift it out of your right side body. So I want both of your sides long and strong. On your inhale, lengthen to the front of your head. On your exhale, pull your belly in, rotate your left ribs over your right, and open your chest to the sky. Inhale, reverse triangle. Push your right big toe straight to your right leg. Bring your left hand to your left thigh, light. Reach your right hand up and back, like you're high-fiving someone standing right behind you. Take one more inhale to reach back, go back, release and close. Exhale, low lunge, cartwheel down, clench your hands, hold the low lunge. Inhale, one-legged high plank, keep your right foot back, keep your toes covered and your hips low. Exhale, bring your right knee to your left elbow across your body. Inhale, fallen star. Shoot your right leg out. Push your right hand down. Reach your left hand high and then forward. Arch to your spine and broaden through your chest. Take an inhale to reach further through your left finger. Exhale, bring your left hand down. Inhale, three-legged dog. Keep your right leg high. Exhale, low lunge. Step through. Gaze forward. Inhale, Jiva squat. Launch your left knee into your right calf on the inhale. Hold. Balance challenge. Bring your hands to heart center. 4, 3, 2. Inhale, 1. Exhale, forward, fold, left knee down. Keep that direction and change my direction. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, bring to the other side. Inhale, chair. Sit back and sit low. Pause and breathe. Think about the depth where you were in the first chair. Go right back to that level or lower. Breathe in. Exhale, chair plane. Arms back, shoulders kissing, ignite your triceps. Inhale, chair, shift the weight to your left foot. Exhale, full airplane or tossing your right leg back, arms back, hinge your body curl to the mat and hold. Feel free to have a bend to your left knee. Square your hips to the ground, left hip up to back, right hip down forward. Belly in, and then in your spine, it's very similar to a locust or cobra if you did on the ground. So you want your shoulder blades engaged, reaching back, and you want to reach the front of your head forward. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, crescent, bend your left knee, land your right toes as they land, lift your torso, bring your biceps by your ears, pause, breathe, and build. Bring a slight bend to your back knee, square your hips off to the front, left back, right forward. If you have test lights, loose your hip bones and try and forward like a car. Absorb your ribs and relax your shoulders. Breathe in. Exhale, revolve, crescent, tap, hands, heart center, shift forward. Tap your right elbow to your left knee for 1 second. In a warrior two, spin your back heel down, stay low on your front leg, cut your arms to the air, plug in. Feel down into the ninth edge of your feet in your arch plank. Your left knee to the wall that is behind you. Stack your shoulders over your hips. Lengthen your arms equally, left to right, gaze forward, perhaps shut down your eyes. Now, friends, how can you start to find a little bit more acceptance of this time, even though it's hard? And how can you start to find trust within yourself to navigate this, even if it continues to get harder? Know that it will come out on the other side at some point. Breathe in. Exhale, extend that angle, Parsvakonasana. Bring your left foot to your left thigh, reach your top and point to the sky. Stay power down into your right leg and lift out of your left side body. I want both sides long and strong. On your inhale, lengthen to the front of your head. On your exhale, pull your belly and rotate your right ribs of your left. You open your chest to the sky. Inhale, reverse triangle. Push your left big toe straight through your left leg. Right hand to right thigh light. Left hand reaches up and back. Put your high thigh into someone behind you. Take one more inhale to reach back and go back. Exhale, low lunge. Heart rail down. Plant your hand. Pull the low right. Inhale, one leg at high plank. Shoot your left foot back. Keep your toes hovering and your hips low. Exhale, bring your left knee to your right elbow across your body. Inhale, falling star. Shoot the left leg out. Push your left hand down. Reach your right hand high and then forward. Arch your spine and broaden your chest. Take one more inhale to reach further through your right finger. Exhale, bring your right hand down. Inhale, breathe like a dog, move your left leg high. Exhale, low lunge, shield and toe step through. Gaze forward, inhale, deep squat, launch your right knee into your left calf. Option down, challenge, hands to heart center. Static, hold for 4, 3, 2, inhale, 1, exhale, forward, fold, dive down. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, your way back to downward facing dog. You can take the chaturanga, or you can simply step back into down dog. Inhale, up dog if you took chaturanga. Exhale, down dog, auto. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, child's pose. Drop to your knees, bring your forehead down, stretch your arms out long in front of you. Take a second, my friends. Catch your breath. Calm your heart, recenter, and refocus your mind. So friends, we flow breath to movement. And just like in life, we've got a lot going on here. There's twists, there's turns, there's challenges everywhere. Rather than running from it or trying to guess what it's gonna be like, can you simply embrace it for what it is? Breathe through those moments of challenge and discomfort. Trust that you can and that you will. We move with that mentality here. And that's what we take with us off our mats and out into a world as well. Take a deep breath in. And a deep breath out. All right, friends, let's flow. Inhale, rise to tabletop. Exhale, downward facing dog, lift up and up. Inhale, gaze forward. Exhale, forward fold, step, floater, handstand, shoot travel to the top. Inhale, halfway left. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chair. Exhale, chair, plane arms back. Inhale, chair, shift the weight to your right foot. Exhale, full airplane with your left leg back. Inhale, crescent, land and rise. Exhale, revolve, crescent, cast, left elbow, right knee. Inhale, warrior two to your left pivot and plug in. Exhale, extend side angle, open through your heart space. Inhale, reverse triangle, stretch in your right side body. Exhale, low lunge, come down. Inhale, one leg at high plank, right leg back. Exhale, knee across your body. Inhale, falling star, reach and shine. Exhale, bring your hand down. Inhale, knee that you drop, right leg high. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, keep the squat, left knee, right calf. Exhale, forward fold. I switch sides, keep going your way. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, chair, sit lower than before. Exhale, chair, plane, arms back. Inhale, chair, reach your left foot. Exhale, full airplane with your right leg back, move with grace. Inhale, crescent, land and rise into acceptance. Exhale, revolve, crescent, have release that means to avoid. Inhale, warrior two, plug into your own power, your potential. Exhale, extend the side angle, open to the growth and the change. Inhale, reverse triangle, you can. Exhale, low lunge, we're in it together. Inhale, one-legged high plank. Exhale, knee across your body. Inhale, falling star, open body, mind, heart. Exhale, bring your hands down. Inhale, squeeze like a dog, keep your left leg high. Exhale, low lunge, step through. Gaze forward, inhale, diva squat, right knee in the left calf. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, your way back to downward facing dog, chaturanga or not, your call. Inhale, up dog, urge up, you took chaturanga. Exhale, down dog, uphill. All right, friends, we're doing one more time through. Stay in it, stay present, stay open. Inhale, gaze forward. Exhale, forward fold, step your hands down to the top. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, chair, feel the strength. Exhale, chair, plane, breathe through the discomfort. Inhale, chair, reach your right foot. Exhale, full airplane, left leg back, navigate with as much grace as you can. Inhale, crescent, rise into the acceptance. Exhale, revolve, crescent, tap, release the resistance. Inhale, warrior two, plug in strong. Exhale, extended side angle, open up, faithful. Inhale, reverse triangle. You've got it. Nice flow, friend. Exhale, low lunge. Come on down. Inhale, one-legged high plank. Exhale, knee cross body. Inhale, falling star. Open up to the possibility. Exhale, bring your hands down. Inhale, three-legged dog. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, deep squat. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, forward fold. You got one more side, one more time. Inhale, chair, Kanasana. Exhale, chair, plane. Inhale, chair, reach your left foot. Exhale, full airplane with right leg back, Sarkasana. Inhale, crescent, Anjaneyasana. Exhale, revolve, crescent, tap, right elbow, left knee. Inhale, warrior two, your Bhadrasana two. Exhale, extend plane angle, Parsvakonasana. Inhale, reverse triangle, Trikonasana. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, one-legged high plank, Ekapada. Exhale, knee across your body. Inhale, falling star. Exhale, hands down. Inhale, three-legged dog. Exhale, low lunge. Inhale, deep squat. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, listen to the chain. Exhale, crawl, pose the Kasana if you want it. Plant your hands, bend your elbows, bring your knees to the back of your triceps, above your elbows, below your shoulders. Keep your gaze forward. Pat your spine as you pull your belly in. Shift forward. Maybe you start to float your feet. Now, you don't have to do crow. Whatever layer you're in, if you're trying it, know that you're good where you are. Breathe into that space. Four, three, two, one. Exhale, step or float back through the vinyasa. We meet in downward facing dog. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Big breath in. Open mouth, exhale, let go. And drop to your knees. Take a seat, grab some water. And tell off, well-deserved break, friends. All right, how are we doing? Can I get some thumbs up if you're doing good? All right, so good, friends. So amazing again that we have this opportunity to be flowing all together. And again, working on that mentality of really being present and open, even when it's hard, and continuing to go forward with that trust in yourself. That's what it's all about. We're working with that here. We take it with us out there.
All right, once you're talcum water, we meet on our backs, and we're gonna move into a little bit more core cultivation to prep us for what we have coming up in a little bit.
So I want you to roll down onto your back, and then come onto your left side. So you're on your left hip. Your left arm can go out long, or you can bring your hand behind your head. Stack your heels to the top of your mat, and then your right fingers overhead. We're working on our side bodies a lot today for this. We bring our fingers and toes together, apart, it's exhale, inhale, contract that space between your bottom rib and your right hip bone. As you lift your leg, keep it going, keep it strong. Here we go for 4, 3, 2, and 1, switch it out. Roll onto your right side. Either extend your right arm long or take the hand behind your head. Heel to the top, left hand overhead. Here we go. Fingers, toes, together, apart. Together, apart. Is exhale, inhale. Exhale, inhale. Contract that space between your ribs and your hips. Feel the activation. One last set right here of 4, 3, 2, and 1. Release. Well done onto your back. Take a wall-to-wall stretch. Fingers towards the back. Go towards the front. Take a deep breath in. Open up, exhale, and let go. Hug your knees into your chest and give yourself a sweep. Grab behind your thighs, rock and roll forward and back. Come out to boat pose, Navasana. Catch yourself at the top. Once you're here, I want you to pull your belly button down and in. I want you to flood your shoulders down your back and lift your strength to the top of your room. Bring your hands behind your head. Same elbow to same knee, boat bicycle. So bring left elbow, left knee together. Right knee, right elbow together. Left, right, left. Right, is exhale, exhale, inhale through the center. Working the entirety of your core, but again, focus on obliques. Keep it going, keep it breathing through the challenge, through the burn. Trust you can. Here for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Center in 2, 1. Hold it center, static hold. Here for 4, 3, 2, and 1. Release. Cross your ankles. Grab onto your knees, your shin. Inhale, cow, lift your chest and gaze up. Exhale, cat, belly to spine and round. Inhale, cow, lift your chest and gaze up. Exhale, cat, belly to spine and round. Inhale, roll up to a seat. Grab some more water and towel off. Amazing work, friends. I know that's a challenge. Once you're held in water, we'll meet back in downward facing dog and we'll continue our flow from there. All right, friends, downward facing dog is where we meet. 4, 3, 2, and downward facing dog. Catch your Ujjayi breath as you're ready for it. Slow your heart rate. And recommit to the intention. Presence, acceptance, even in the face of challenge. Openness to the growth, to the change. Trusting in yourself, trusting in the process. Breathe in and breathe out. Inhale, three-legged dog, send your right leg high into the sky. Exhale, low lunge, shield and toe step through. Inhale, crescent lunge, Anjaneyasana, rise up. Exhale, revolve, crescent lunge. Bring your hips to our center, shift forward and twist left elbow to the outside of your right knee. This time we're holding it longer than the tap variation we did in our sun beat. So on your inhales, lengthen through the front of your head. On your exhales, pull your belly in, push your right hand down into your left, and rotate your heart closer to your thumbs to help you deepen your twist. That's it. Take another round of breath in. Inhale, gaze down your right foot. Shift the weight forward. Exhale, prayer twist. Step your left toes up to meet your right. Keep the twist in your upper body. But keep your knees squeezed together in one line. Sit your hips lower than your shoulders. The twist in your upper body is the exact same as revolved crescent. Find those same muscle actions here. Shift the weight into your left foot. Start to lift your right heel. Inhale, revolve one leg and down knee. Lift your right knee up. Maintain the pressure of your elbow to your knee and your knee back into your elbow. Hold the twist in the sky. Breathe in and breathe out. Inhale, full one-legged mountain. Keep your knee up, undo the twist. Reach your torso and your arms up. Exhale, eagle on the right. Cross your right arm under your left. Cross your elbows, wrist palms cut. Or grab opposite shoulder. Cross your right leg over your left. Sit back, toes can hover. Kick center, cover out behind your calf. I'm going to turn to face you here. Now, pull your elbows and knees down the center line of your body. Lift your elbows and left your shoulders. Draw them forward in a way to stretch between your shoulder blades. Sit lower on your legs, squeeze back, grow taller in your spine. Breathe. Inhale, one-legged mountain. Unravel and rise, right knee up. Exhale, tree vrikshasana. Open your right knee to the side. Bring the sole of your foot to your ankle, calf, or inner thigh. Avoid your knee. Push your foot into your leg and your leg back into your foot. The opposition creates stability. Draw your knee over to the sides, pull your belly button up and in. Take one point of focus with your gaze and whatever variation with your arms you'd like to take. Inhale. Exhale, Soma CT, bring your hands down, foot down. Dance out your legs for a second if that feels good. All right, we'll flow it down. Inhale, Mountain Tadasana Rise. Exhale, forward fold, dive down. Inhale, halfway lift, total your feet, hips distance. Exhale, gorilla Padmasana. Lift your toes up, insert your hands underneath your feet. Bend your knees as much as you need to. Bring your toes all the way to your wrist. Massage your fingers, hands, and wrists with the pressure of your toes and your feet. Let your head hang heavy to stretch into your spine and breathe. Under the kitchen lights, still look like dynamite. And I wanna end up on you. Oh, don't need a place to go. Release your hand. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, option for another crow or move back to chaturanga. We're going to meet in downward facing dog. Once again, for crow, you plant your hands shoulder distance, bend your elbows, bring your knees back to your triceps. Gaze down like you're reading something right in front of you. Count your spine, pull your belly in, and then maybe you float one foot and then the other foot from the mat. Hold it here for 4, 3, 2, 1, exhale, step or float back through your chaturanga or whatever variation. Knee back and downward facing dog. Inhale, three-legged dog, into your left leg high. Exhale, low lunge, heel bend, toe step through. Inhale, crescent on Janyasana Rise. Exhale, revolve, crescent lunge, hands, heart center, shift forward, twist right over the outside of your left knee. On your inhale, lengthen through the front of your head. On your exhale, pull your belly in. Push your left hand down into your right. Rotate your heart close to your thumb to help you deepen your foot. Take another round of breath. Inhale, gaze down to your left foot. Shift the weight forward. Exhale, prayer twist. Step your right toes up to meet your left. Once again, keep your knees squeezed together in one line and get your hips lower than your shoulders. The twist in your body remains the same as revolved crescent, the same muscle action in spine, core, chest. Shift the weight into your right foot, lift your left heel. Inhale, revolve one leg and mountain. Reach your left knee up, maintain the pressure of your knees, your elbow connection. Hold it here, breathe in. And breathe out. Inhale, one-legged mountain. Keep your left knee high and do the twist. Reach your arms up. Exhale, equal your mouth to the left. Cross your left hand under your right. Cross your elbows, wrist palms, touch your opposite shoulder. Cross your left leg over your right. Sit back, double or single wrap. Once again, I'm going to turn to face you. Awkward transition there. Draw your elbows and knees on the center line of your body. Lift your elbows off your shoulders. Draw them forward in a way to stretch between your shoulder blades. Sit lower on your legs, go taller in your spine, and breathe. Inhale, one-legged mountain, unravel and rise. Reach your left knee high.
Exhale, tree. Open your left knee to the side. You must hold your left foot to the same place you're on the other side. Angle calf or inner thigh. Avoid your knee. Push foot into leg and leg back into foot. Opposition kick stability. Draw your left knee to the side. Pick one foot and hook to your gaze. Whether arm duration works for you, breathe. Inhale. Exhale, Selma CT, toes down, hands to heart center. Once again, dance it out. All right, we flow it down. Inhale, mountain. Exhale, back bend. Inhale, mountain. Exhale, forward fold.
Inhale, halfway lift, listen for change. Exhale, squat and curl, tuck into that low ball shape. Inhale, toe squat. Draw your knees up your hips, lift your chest, bring your hands to heart center and hold. Now, balance may be a challenge here. Zip up your knees and thighs together as one. Imagine pulling your belly button up and underneath your ribs. That actually is going to help keep you lifted. Inhale, grow tall. Exhale, squat, vertical twist. Maintain your legs, right fingers back, left fingers forward. Now, once again, keep your knees together and pointed forward like a prayer twist. On your inhale, grow tall. On your exhale, twist back. Inhale, hands to heart center. Exhale, squat, vertical twist. Keep your legs, left fingers back, right fingers forward and fold. Squeeze your knees, pointing forward. Inhale, go tall and squatting. Exhale, twist back. Inhale, toe squat, hands to center. Exhale, have a seat, grab some water, and tie off once again. All right, friends, we have reached the pinnacle of our practice. We are playing around with side throw, Pati Vritta Vikasana today. We are warmed up for this. Number one, side crow requires a lot of twisting. We've done so much of that. The revolved crescent tap, the revolved crescent lunge to prayer twist to revolve one leg in mountain. So that's all activated. Also requires a lot of side body, one side kind of extending and one side kind of flexing. That's why we did our quarter moons earlier. That's why we did those mermaid fingers and toes together in our core section. So everything is warmed up and ready. It's just about putting the puzzle pieces together. And also remembering that side crow is a hugely difficult arm balance and inversion, but rather than being frustrated with it or trying to muscle your way through it, you have to breathe through it. Accept each part of the process, trust yourself through the process towards that point of growth. That's the mentality that's more important of working with than actually nailing the posture perfectly today. So I'm gonna show you on one side of my body and then we'll move into it all together. So we approach side crow from that squat vertical twist that we just did. That's why we did this. You come to the space and then you bring your hands down, shoulders apart out to the side. The hands are very similar to when you're in a high plank, a chaturanga, a down dog, or a normal crow. Those are all postures we've done throughout our practice. So we put this together with those and you have the basis of the posture. Then from here, you lift your hips similar to in prayer twist or chair pose, and bend your elbows inward, similar to a chaturanga or a normal crow. Bring the outside of your right thigh and the outside of your right hip to the back of your arms. It's right above your elbows and again, below your shoulders. Gaze down like you're reading or out to the side like so. I'm gonna switch a little bit so you can see the rest of this. Once you have that connection, you shift forward. You're kind of extending into your left side body and contracting your right side body. Pull your belly in, eventually you start to float your feet from the ground. You can hold it right here. If you'd like to go the traditional variation, kick your right leg out, the bottom leg out, and then your left leg off to the side. That is side crow, Pati Vritta Vikasana. So we're gonna play around with that. Feel free to play around with anything else that you wanna work on. Again, you don't actually have to do this. And again, trust each step as we move through this and feel really good about wherever you get to. So let's do it. Start on your right side. So come to your toe squat, twist over to the right, bring your hands down, shoulder distance apart, middle fingers point directly forward. Lift your hips, bend your elbows, bring the outside of your right thigh and the outside of your right hip to the back of your arms above your elbows. Gaze down like you're reading or out to the side. Contract your right side body, pull your belly in, float your feet from the mat if that feels good. If you want the split, kick your right leg out and send your left leg back behind you for a side crow. I'll give you another couple moments to pray there.
play there, and then I'll walk you through the other side. Good, I see some nice variations, friends. Strong. All right, meet me back at the center. Again, come to your squat, and then move into the vertical twist, left. Bring your hands down, shoulder distance apart. Lift your hips, bend your elbows. Bring the outside of your left thigh and your left hip to the back of your arms. It is down leg reading or off to the side. Pull your belly in, pull the sides of your waist in, particularly the left side. Maybe you float your feet. Maybe you kick your left leg out and right leg out behind you for a side crow. A couple moments to play there. So good, friends. All right. Once you're done, come on down to a squat. Take your right hand, reach back, pat yourself on the back. Nice work, everyone. All right. We're going to lay down onto our bellies here. So come all the way down to a prone Shavasana pose. Plant your hands at the top of your mat, elbows out to the side. Bring your left cheek to the mat. Take an inhale. Exhale, prone half frog. Pull your right knee up and in towards your armpit as high as you can get it. And then relax down. This is gonna gently spread and open into your hips. It's a sustainable stretch for your hip joints. And relax. You were right. I know I can't get enough of you. Leave it all blue. You were right. I know I can't get enough of you. No. Things that I... Inhale, bring your chin to center. Exhale, send your right leg long behind you, and we'll switch it out. Exhale, prone half frog on the other side. Bring your right cheek to the mat. Pull your left knee up and in towards your arm to that side. You can get it. And relax down. So once again, friends, circling back to our intention together today. We're in a time that is uncertain, that is challenging, that is uncomfortable. And rather than avoiding that, we have to accept it. Rather than resisting it, we have to lean into it. There's no hiding from this. We have to just keep going, keep breathing. Stay open to the opportunities for growth that there might be here. And trust ourselves through this. And that doesn't mean that it's all going to be easy, that there won't be moments that are particularly hard, that there won't be tragedies and losses. But it is our present. We breathe, we trust, we navigate. That's what you've practiced here today on your mat. Now it's about taking that with you off your mat as you go forward into the rest of your days. Inhale, bring your chin back to center. Exhale, extend your left leg long behind you. Push up onto a stand on your knees. So bring your knees hip distance apart. Stack your hips over your knees and your shoulders over your hips. Bring your hands to the small of your back as if they're slipping down into pockets. Try and make your elbows disappear behind you. Inhale, bring your gaze up to a spot on the ceiling right above you. Exhale, camel Ushtrasana. Very slowly lock your gaze down the ceiling 1 inch at a time. As your gaze goes back, send your hips forward, lift your chest up and forward. Continue to breathe smoothly through your nose, either ujjayi breath or small sips of air. Inhale, slowly walk your gaze back forward till your chin is level. Exhale, have a seat on your heels, bring your hands to your thighs, allow your eyes to close, and let any sensations that arose pass. Blink your eyes open.
come to a seat. Extend both of your legs long in front of you and zip up your legs together as one. Flex your toes back with your shins. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, do the forward fold posture, Uttanasana. Fold forward, bend your knees as much as you need to grab onto your feet, invite your chin to your chest, your forehead towards your knees. Flying the length down your spine, across your low back, and in between your shoulder blades. You were right. Inhale, slowly roll up one vertebra at a time. Scoot forward to your plenty of mat space available behind you. Lower all the way down into your back from the mat. Hug both knees into your chest. Squeeze. Take an inhale. Exhale, happy baby, and Dandavalasana. Reach your come onto the inside or outside arches of your feet. Draw your knees down to your ribs. If this feels too intense, you can always grab behind your knees or your thighs. Seal your lower back down. You can remain in stillness or you can rock side to side. Inhale, come to center. Exhale, hug your knees in. Bring your forward up to your knees, tuck your toes back to your face, squeeze into a tight, tiny ball. Exhale, Shavasana, let your legs go long and your arms go long. Relax and melt down. Release movement, find stillness. Keep external thoughts at bay, stay present in silence. And as you rest, your friends, I will guide you through a visualization meditation for the first part of our practice, our Shavasana. And then I will allow you to drift off on your own. Visualize in your mind's eye floating above you a ball of blue light. It can be whatever shade of blue you prefer. It can be a perfect ball or sphere. It can look more like a moon, a sun, a star. Whatever your imagination paints, see that in the full detail. As you breathe in, visualize drinking in rays of this light. That blue light floods through your nostrils, down your throat, enters your lungs. And as it does, your body warms and strengthens. And as you breathe out, from the top of the ball, the sphere, see rays of the light shoot out through the ceiling, through the windows. They travel off to be dispersed into the world, shared with others. Breathe this in, breathe this out. See this, feel this, and let everything else melt away. Thank you.
Feel free to remain here in Shavasana for a few minutes longer if you'd like a little bit more time. If you are ready to move on with your day, let's take a soft inhale and a soft exhale. On your next inhale, invite gentle movements back. Bring wiggles to your fingers and your toes. Bring rotations to your wrists and your ankles. And gently rock your head side to side on the mat. Move into a wall-to-wall stretch. Reach your fingers to the back, point your toes towards the front, arch your spine up off the mat. And gather your knees into your chest and give yourself a sweep. Roll to your left side in the fetal position. Use your left bicep as a pillow. Plant your right hand down on the ground as a base. Take a moment and a breath there. When you're ready, make your way up to a comfortable seat. Eyes remain closed and bring your hands to heart center. We end our practice as we began with our breath, with our intention. Open mouth, exhale, let all your air go and anything else you need to release. One last time together, inhale, breathe into this space of acceptance, openness, trust, and growth. Open mouth, exhale, breathe this around you, take this with you as you go. Bring your thumbs up to your third eye center, space of enlightenment, intuition. Loka, Samasta, Sukhinu, Bhavantu. May all beings ever be happy and free, and may the words and actions of our own lives now contribute to and impact that very same happiness and freedom. From this space, we bow forward to seal our practice. The highest in me sees and honors the highest in you. Namaste.
Namaste.
Practice, my friends. Thank you so much for coming and sharing your energy. It's so great to be able to flow with all of you. Please continue to come to these classes. I'll continue to update my Instagram, my website with all the links and the things that you need. Moving forward, there will be a password for Zoom, which I'll definitely include. Classes continue to be community-based and free. If you would like to make a donation, it's graciously appreciated. You can Venmo me at Johnny-Nunez. But other than that, I really just want you to continue coming and practicing so that we have this opportunity to connect. Feel free to share with others on social media and go forth and keep doing the thing, friends. I'll see you again real soon. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Johnny. Thank you. Thank you. Love you. Bye.
Bye. Bye.